dear friends, welcome back to this lecture series. In this series, in first lecture, we discuss type 1, that is stereochemistry of 1,1 disubstituted cyclohexane. In second lecture, we discuss type 2, that is stereochemistry of 1,2 disubstituted cyclohexane. 1,2 disubstituted cyclohexane shows geometrical isomerism. That's why we saw cis 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane and trans 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane in our second lecture. This is my third lecture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss type 3, that is 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane. Type 3. 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane. What is meant by 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane? The compound in which substituents are present with respect to 1,3 position of cyclohexane is called as 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane. See this, 6 member carbon ring is called as cyclohexane, and substituents are present with respect to 1,3 position. This is 1, 2, 3. So substituents are present with respect to 1,3 position called as 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane. Like 1,2 disubstituted cyclohexane, 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane is also shows geometrical isomerism. As I told you, 1,1 disubstituted cyclohexane do not shows geometrical isomerism. 1,1 disubstituted cyclohexane do not shows geometrical isomerism. 1,2, 1,3 and 1,4 disubstituted cyclohexane shows geometrical isomerism. Geometrical means cis trans isomerism. So 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane shows geometrical isomerism. Let us consider a simple example. 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane shows geometrical isomerism. One is cis 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane and another geometrical isomer is trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. So remember, 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane shows geometrical isomerism. One is cis and another one is trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. This 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane, this cis isomer. See this, methyl is up, both methyl on same side. That's why this is cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. In this case, again 1,2,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. This methyl is up, this methyl is down. So opposite side, that's why this isomer is called as trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. This is 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. This is cis isomer and this is trans isomer. Right? So remember, 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane shows geometrical isomerism, that is cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane and trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Let's talk in detail about cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Cis means both substituents are on same side, either they are both are axial. See, this carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. This carbon having methyl up. So methyl at C3 is also up. This is cis isomer. Both methyl group at on same side. That's why called as cis isomer. Cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Both substituents are either axial. So ring flipping convert this axial into equatorial. Remember, cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane has two conformational isomer. Cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane has two conformational isomer. In one conformation, both methyl at axial position called as axial, and this conformer on ring flipping gives another conformer in which both methyl group at equatorial called as equatorial. So remember, cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane shows two conformer, one is XLXL and another one is equatorial, right? This XLXL ring clipping, this XLXL is converted into equatorial. These are two main conformer for this cis 1,3 di substituted cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane, right? Then let us try to draw the various conformation for cis 1,3 di substituted cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Draw various conformation structure for cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. This first conformer in which both methyl group axial, right? This is 1, 2, 3, carbon number 1, 2, 3, right? Methyl XLXL. What happened after ring clipping? Ring clipping means what? Conversion of one chair into another chair. If you move this carbon to lower side, up this carbon, so convert this one ring into the another ring, this phenomenon is called as ring clipping. Conversion of one chair into the another chair is called as ring clipping. In conformer 1, both methyl group at axial position, but due to the ring clipping, what happened? Due to the ring clipping, XLXL methyl group is converted into equatorial. Then this conformer 1 having mirror image of this conformer 3. So these are two mirror images, non-superimposable mirror images. Then conformer 2 having also mirror image of this. So conformer 2 and conformer 4 are also the non-superimposable mirror image. These are the various conformation of cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Let us talk about its optical isomerism. Optical isomerism means optical activity. What we expected? This molecule is optically active or inactive. See this molecule, this cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane is optically inactive. Why it is optically inactive? Cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane is optically inactive because of this plane of symmetry. See this plane of symmetry passing through C2 C5 carbon. That's why this compound is optically inactive. Same here, see this compound. In this structure, both methyl group at equatorial, this compound is also optically inactive. Why it is optically inactive? It is optically inactive because of plane of symmetry passing through C2C5 carbon. So remember, the cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane has plane of symmetry passing through C2C5 carbon, therefore it is optically inactive. Cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane has plane of symmetry passing through this C2C5 carbon. That's why this molecule is optically inactive due to the presence of plane of symmetry. Let us talk about its relative stability. Two conformer, this is one conformer in which both methyl group at axial position. This is another conformer when both methyl group at equatorial position. No doubt this conformation is more stable conformation. Why this is more stable? Because bulky group at equatorial position is always more stable. This is more stable conformation. And this conformation having energy 0 kilocalorie per mole. As I told you, methyl group at equatorial position shows interaction in case of 1,2 disubstituted cyclohexane only. Methyl at equatorial do not shows interaction in case of 1,3 and 1,4 disubstituted cyclohexane. So here methyl is equatorial, so this methyl does not shows any interaction. That's why the total energy for this molecule is 0 kilocalorie per mole. Let us talk about this conformer 1. In this conformer, both methyl group at axial position. And we know that one axial methyl group shows two butane gauge interaction, 2,1,3 diaxial interaction with C3 hydrogen and C5 hydrogen. So this axial methyl produced 2 butane gauge interaction. This axial methyl group produced 2 butane gauge interaction. So total how many butane gauge interaction? 2 plus 2, that is 4 butane gauge interaction or 4,1,3 diaxial interaction. So total energy for this molecule is 4 into 0.9. For one interaction, energy is 0.9 kilocalorie per mole. Total 4 butane gauge interaction, 4 butane gauge or 4,1,3 diaxial interaction. That's why total energy is 4 into 0.9. 4 into 0.9. That is 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. But it is found that total energy of this molecule is 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. Why 5.4 kilocalorie per mole? Because this molecule is also shows one additional steric interaction between this methyl-methyl. So this methyl-methyl interaction having energy 1.8. Initial, total 4 butane gauge interaction, 4 butane gauge interaction, 4 into 0.9. Total energy is 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. But this two bulky group shows additional 1.8 kilocalorie steric interaction. Therefore, total energy is 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. As I told you, 1,3 diequatorial cis form is more stable, do not show any interaction. That's why total energy is 0 kilocalorie per mole. So this molecule shows total energy 0 kilocalorie per mole. Again, I repeat, in this conformer, the methyl group at equatorial position do not shows interaction. In case of 1,2 disubstituted cyclohexane, remember, in 1,2 disubstituted cyclohexane, equatorial methyl group shows interaction, but in 1,3 and 1,4, equatorial methyl group do not shows any interaction. So here, methyl at equatorial do not shows interaction. That's why total energy for this molecule is 0 kilocalorie per mole. In conformer 1, both methyl group at axial, as I told you, one axial methyl group shows 2 butane gauge interaction. Here we have 2 axial methyl group. So total butane gauge interactions are 4. Total 1,3 diaxial interactions are 4. That's why total energy is 4 into 0.9. That is 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. But this molecule shows total energy 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. Why this molecule shows 5.4 kilocalorie per mole? Because here this additional two bulky methyl group shows steric interaction having energy 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. That's why total energy is equal to 3.6 plus 1.8 is equal to 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. This is all about cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. Just recap the things what we learn in this lecture. We are talking about type 3, that is 1,3-disubstituted cyclohexane. 1,3-disubstituted cyclohexane, substituents are present with respect to 1,3 position called as 1,3-disubstituted cyclohexane. 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane shows geometrical isomerism. One is cis isomer, another one is trans isomer. This is 1,3 disubstituted cyclohexane. This is cis isomer, both methyl group at same side called as cis isomer. Methyl group on opposite side called as trans isomer. Then we are talking about this cis isomer, cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. It has two forms, it has two conformation. In one conformation, both methyl group at axial, that's why called as both methyl group at axial called as axial-axial, and this conformer on ring flipping, axial-axial is converted into equatorial-equatorial. These are the two conformational isomer for cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. Remember, cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane has two conformational isomer. One is cis, in both substituents are either axial or substituents are equatorial. Then we draw the various conformation for this 1,3-cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. This is the first conformation in which both methyl group at axial. Then this compound on ring clipping gives equatorial equatorial. Then we have mirror image of compound 1. Conformer 1 shows mirror image conformer 3. Conformer 2 shows mirror image conformer 4. Then we discuss regarding the optical isomerism. In optical isomerism, we discuss regarding optical activity. So this molecule is optically inactive. Why this molecule is optically inactive? Because of plane of symmetry passing through C2 and C5 carbon. Due to this plane of symmetry, these compounds are cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. Cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane is optically inactive. Right? So remember, cis 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane is optically inactive because of plane of symmetry passing through C2, C5. Then we calculate energy for this conformation. This one conformation in which both methyl group at axial, this another conformation when both methyl group at equatorial. As I told you, methyl group at equatorial position will be more stable. That's why this conformation having 0 kilocalorie per mole energy. This most unstable conformation in which two methyl group at axial position. As I told you, methyl at axial shows two butane-Gauch interaction. Here we have two methyl group. That's why total four butane-Gauch interaction, four 1,3 diaxial interaction. That's why total energy is equal to 0.4 into 9, that is 3.4 kilocalorie per mole, 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. But overall, this molecule shows 5.4 kilocalorie per mole energy. Total energy 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. Why 5.4 kilocalorie per mole? Because in addition to 1,3 diaxial interaction, butane-Gauch interaction, this bulky methyl group shows steric interaction having energy 1.8. So 0.9 into 4 is equal to 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. Plus additional bulky group shows energy 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. That's why total energy is 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. So this axial-axial shows 5.4 kilocalorie per mole energy. Equatorial-equatorial shows 0 kilocalorie per mole energy. This is all about cis isomer. Let us discuss regarding trans isomer. This trans 1, 2, 3. This trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. In trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane, substituents are, one substituent is axial while another substituent is at equatorial position. This compound is also shows two chair conformation, two conformational isomer, but both conformational isomers are identical. This first conformation. See, methyl at carbon number 1 is axial and methyl at carbon number 3 is equatorial. See, this methyl moving upward, this methyl moving downward. So opposite side, that's why called as trans isomer. So in trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane, one methyl group is axial and another methyl group at equatorial position. What happened after ring clipping? What is meant by ring clipping? Conversion of one chair into the another chair called as ring clipping. Ring clipping, move this carbon to lower side, lift this carbon to upper side. So convert this chair into the another chair. See, carbon which is upper, now it is lower. What happened in ring clipping? In ring clipping, group which is axial become equatorial and equatorial become axial. See, methyl at C1 is axial. After ring clipping, it becomes equatorial. Methyl which is equatorial, after ring clipping, methyl is axial. So these are the two conformational isomer, but both conformational 5 and 6 are identical, because in both conformer, one methyl is axial and another one is equatorial. So remember, trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane has two chair conformation, conformation 5 and 6, both conformations are identical. In trans isomer, one substituent is axial and another one is equatorial. Mirror image of these compounds are, so 5, this conformer 5 shows mirror image, conformer 7, these two are the mirror image, conformer 6 having mirror image, conformer 8, so these two are the mirror image. So these are the various conformations of trans 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. These are the various conformation of trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. Let us discuss regarding optical isomerism. What we expected? This molecule must be optically active. Why it is optically active? Because of absence of plane of symmetry. As I told you, cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane is optically inactive because of plane of symmetry passing through C2C5 carbon. But in trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, plane of symmetry is absent. That's why we expected this molecule must be optically active. See this compound, this conformational isomer 5 and 7 are non-superimposable mirror image, that is enantiomer. 6 and 8 are also non-superimposable mirror image, that is enantiomer. Compound 5 on ring flipping gives compound 6. Compound 7 on ring flipping gives compound 8. All these are identical. Hence, they are exist in racemic mixture, and racemic mixtures are optically inactive. So trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, there is no plane of symmetry, hence expected it must be optically active. As I told you, structure 5 and 7, 6 and 8 produce identical compound, and all these conformation having equal stability. Why equal stability? Because in all conformation, one methyl group is axial and another one is equatorial. That's why these all conformation having equal stability, right? This is all about optical isomerism. Let us calculate relative stability for this compound. In trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, one methyl group is axial and another one is equatorial. Methyl which is equatorial do not shows any interaction. Methyl group at equatorial do not shows any interaction, but methyl which is axial shows 2-butane-Gauch interaction or 1,3-diaxial interaction. Methyl group at C1 carbon shows 1,3-diaxial interaction, 1,3-diaxial interaction with C3 hydrogen, C5 hydrogen. So methyl group at C1 shows butane-Gauch interaction with C3 hydrogen and C5 hydrogen, and the energy for one interaction is 0.9 kilocalorie per mole. Total we have two interactions, that's why energy is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So remember, energy of all these four structure is same. This conformer having 1.8, this conformer having 1.8 kilocalorie per mole energy. All these conformer having same energy, equal stability, right? So total energy for trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. If you compare this trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane with cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, let us talk about its order of stability. Cis equatorial form is more stable. Cis 1,3 equatorial form is more stable. Why it is more stable? It has energy 0 kilocalorie per mole. Most unstable form is cis 1,3 axial. Cis 1,3 axial shows energy 5.4 kilocalorie per mole, whereas this trans isomer shows energy intermediate between cis equatorial equatorial and cis axial axial, that is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So remember, cis-1,3 equatorial is most stable conformation having energy 0 kilocalorie per mole, where cis axial axial is most unstable conformation having energy 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. Trans-1,3 axial equatorial or equatorial axial shows energy 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. This is all about trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. So we are talking about this trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. Trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, it has two chair conformation, but both chair conformations are identical. It has two chair conformation. This is one conformation. In one conformation, methyl group at C1 is axial and methyl group at C3 is equatorial. This conformation on ring clipping gives conformation 6, conformation 5 and conformation 6. So trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane has two chair conformation, but both conformations are identical. In both conformation, remember, one methyl group is axial and another methyl group is equatorial. Conformer 5 is mirror image of conformation 7. Conformation 6 and conformation 8 are also the mirror image. Conformer 5 on ring clipping gives conformer 6. Conformer 7 on ring clipping gives conformer 8. These are the various conformation for trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. Let us discuss optical isomerism. What we expected, this molecule, this trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, there is no plane of symmetry. No plane of symmetry, that's why we expected this molecule must be optically active. But in actual case, structure 5 and structure 7 are non-superimposable mirror image, that is enantiomer. Structure 6 and structure 8 are also the non-superimposable mirror image. That's why 5 and 7, 6 and 8 are the enantiomer. 5 on ring clipping. Ring clipping, conversion of one chair into another chain. So 5 on ring clipping gives 6, 7 on ring clipping gives 8. So all these are identical structure. All these compound having equal stability, because in all structure, one methyl group is axial and another one is equatorial. So all these structure having equal stability. Let us calculate its energy. In all conformation, one methyl is axial and another one is equatorial. As I told you, methyl at equatorial do not shows any interaction. Methyl at axial shows interaction. Methyl which is axial shows interaction with C3 hydrogen and C5 hydrogen. So this methyl group shows 2 butane gauge interaction or 2,1,3-diaxial interaction, and the interaction, the energy for one interaction is 0.9. So total we have 2 interaction, that's why total energy is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. Total energy is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. All these 4 conformer having equal stability, having energy 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. Remember, trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane has only energy 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. Let us compare this trans 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane with cis 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. If you compare this trans isomer with cis isomer, let us talk the stability order for this conformer. Cis equatorial is the most stable conformation. As I told you, cis 1,3 is more stable. Cis 1,3-diequatorial is more stable because both methyl group at equatorial do not shows any interaction, having energy 0 kilocalorie per mole. Most unstable is cis 1,3-axial-axial. As I told you, cis 1,3-axial-axial shows total energy 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. This is most unstable. And trans axial equatorial shows energy intermediate between cis equatorial and cis axial axial conformer. So trans 1,3-axial equatorial shows energy 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. This is most unstable form of 1,3-disubstituted-dimethylcyclohexane. This is all about type 3, that is 1,3-disubstituted cyclohexane. So overall, we discussed regarding type 1, 1,1 disulfide cyclohexane, type 2, 1,2 disulfide cyclohexane, type 3, 1,3 disulfide cyclohexane. In next lecture, we will discuss regarding stereochemistry of 1,4 disulfide cyclohexane, that is type 4, stereochemistry of 1,4 disulfide cyclohexane. Thank you.